We're the sixth longest cave in the world. We're probably right around 160 miles of explored passageway, but we're not even the longest cave in the county. Jewel Cave, with over 200 miles of passageway, is actually longer than we are. But it's like twins separated at birth. You go on a tour at Wind Cave, you go on a tour at Jewel Cave, and they're just totally different caves.
Just 19 miles apart by air, both Jewel and Wind Cave are in Custer County. Tom Farrell says it's not known if the two are somehow connected, but studies have shown that the two caves breathe in different rhythm. Yes, the caves breathe.
Well, it's an aptly named cave. The natural opening to the cave is very small, and the cave is so large it acts like a barometer. So you can actually predict the weather with it. When there's a low front moving in, like a storm, there's more air pressure inside the cave than out, so the cave breathes out. And if there's a high front moving in, or typically good weather, it pushes air in, and you get the airflow going in the opposite direction. It's pretty amazing what the wind can do. What I like to do is I like to go down there on a winter day when it's softly snowing and it's breathing out, and just get the feeling there's something big down there.
Bigger than you imagine. Estimates say that less than 10% of the cave has been mapped, and bigger because of what's on the surface. The cave is the star, but Wind Cave, the eighth national park created, also includes a wildlife preserve for bison and elk and places to explore above and below ground.
I mean, you can take a hike with 30 miles of hiking trails. You can hike up to Rankin Ridge, the highest point in the park. It's a great place to come have a picnic or watch sunset from there. Can come and go on a tour. And you know, what's special about our cave is that you're going to see something you're not going to see in any other cave. And this boxwork formation, this honeycomb formation hanging from the walls and the ceilings. That's just, we have the best example of boxwork found in the world. We were kind of surprised recently when the Mars rover took pictures and it had a rock that appeared to be looking like boxwork. So we have the best boxwork in the solar system.
Part of our story is of a sacred place. Some are told in books or oral traditions. Some live in the hearts of the people bound to those traditions. Wind Cave occupies both a physical and a spiritual space. It's one of the reasons why these Black Hills are so very important to Native culture. It starts long before Europeans arrived, before the buffalo were nearly destroyed, then reborn, before Charlie Crary or the Bingham brothers squeezed into the cave with a candle and some string. The oral history of the Lakota people told of a wind that blew up from the underworld into this world. It happened right in this place, a place both temporal and eternal, mythical and real, where the Lakota people emerged into the world with a breath of life.
The story begins at a time before there were plants and animals were just being brought into existence. There are no people and no bison on earth. The people were in the spirit world waiting for the earth to be ready for them. But there were two spirits on earth that tricked the people by sending a wolf in carrying delicious items of food and clothing that had some of the people follow the wolf back out while others waited following the creator's instructions. The people that followed him out came to a beautiful place. One of the tricksters taught them how to hunt, how to tan hides, but the people found the work very difficult and they were very slow. When winter arrived, they weren't ready for it. They went back to the trickster for help, and she just laughed at them. And they tried to return to the spirit world, but the portal was blocked. So they didn't know what else to do, so they sat down and just cried. And the creator heard their cries and asked them why they were there. They explained what they had done, and he was very, very angry with them. And so as a punishment, he turned them into bison. When the earth was finally ready for the humans, the rest emerged. They saw this track of a bison. They were told to follow this bison because the bison will provide everything you need to exist on earth. And meanwhile, the creator shrank that opening down so it can never return, yet never forget where they came from. And this is just part of their oral tradition, part of their emergence story in terms of that's been passed down from one generation to another. So it really speaks to the importance of this place to the Lakota people.